Now, the plan of practicing is very simple. You would take one small fragment, maybe 4-8 bars, let's say sentence, and you would play it in different tempos from slow to fast, repeating in every tempo as many times as it takes to play and feel comfortable. Then you would need to make the same routine with every sentence in the piece, with every 2 sentences, with every 4 sentences, 8 sentences, and so on, till you're able to play the whole piece. Easy. But we're all humans, and we all have our own fears, doubts, and habits that would make this simple plan almost impossible to follow. So here are the tips for you to get through this plan successfully and hopefully finish the piece within a couple of days. So tip number one, be patient. That means that you need to accept the fact that out of 10 times, you're gonna play 9 times feeling complete disaster, feeling so uncomfortable, struggling with focusing on all the tasks that you need to make while playing. 9 times you would feel that your fingertips and your fingers feel nothing. 9 times you would feel that you cannot control anything, that everything is just falling apart. 9 times you would know that you can never make it. 9 times you would really feel that something is really wrong with you. And then on the 10th time, all of a sudden everything will become easier, more settled in your mind, in your muscle sensations. So you always need to remember that on this way of practicing, there's always this wave that goes down. So everything will get worse at some point, but then at the end, everything will get better. So you shouldn't stop at that low point. And it's like reading the book, and then, you know, you would stop reading it somewhere in the middle where hero would start having some problems, some struggles with life. So if you stop there, you will never know that actually the end of the book, the hero was fine again. So sadly, we cannot skip any pages of our book of practicing. We just need to know that this is it, this is the process, you have to accept it, you have to go through this, and just be patient and have faith in a way. What is wrong with me? I'm doing something wrong again. I will never play it as I want. Great, and now I feel it becomes even worse. Why is it so uncomfortable? Why my fingers are not moving? What is wrong? It will never work out. Okay. Alright. I have to accept that 9 times I will not feel well while playing. Okay. That's hard and sad though, but well, that's the process and this is what it is, and I will keep repeating it with cold head and see what will happen. I'll go through this. What is happening? Was it accidentally? What did I do? Can I repeat it again? What if I can't repeat it again? Oh my god, now I'm scared. I can't repeat it again. Okay, I'm gonna try again. Oh my god, it works! It feels so easy now! It's easy to play now! I can do it! I could make it! Yay!
And trust me, after some time, you won't have to go through this dialogue again because you will know that you can do it. And you will just keep practicing, keep repeating as many times as it takes, no matter what. Tip number two, be aware. That means you need to focus completely on the music you're playing while practicing. And if you feel and if you notice that at one point your mind starts wandering about the stuff that has nothing to do with music that you're playing, you should stop, you should gently correct yourself and start over again.
Oh, how others can do it? That girl from my class, she always could make it so easy. Her technique was so good.
what if I could never be a good pianist? I'll practice and practice and practice all day long, and it's just all hopeless. Oh, my friend's party is tonight. Who's gonna come? Will he be there? Oh, I could wear that amazing black dress and to make that hair. Wait, what? Where am I? Oh god, I was completely out. How did that happen? Okay, focus, focus. Never mind, we'll try again. Alright, okay. Focus, focus, focus. And here we go.
And again, by practicing awareness, that will make one day so easy and so effortless for you to focus on music during the whole time of practicing. And the last tip, but not least at all, be cautious. That means that no matter how passionate and determined you are to go through this plan, to repeat non-stop, to reach your goal, to finish it finally, you have to be always cautious about your hand state, because this stage is very dangerous, as you repeat the same movements and that can cause unhealthy heavy tension in hands. And so if you continue ignoring this tension or don't want to like notice those tensions, that might lead to some injuries of your hands. So as soon as you feel that you start accumulating this heaviness in hands that prevents you from controlling of your tone, then you should really, really stop immediately, no matter how badly you want to continue. And I would suggest to make this breathing exercise where you would take, let's say, 10 inhales, and then with exhales, you would kind of exhale all tension in hands. That will cool your also head a little bit. Then you can continue. Then if this exercise already doesn't help, then you should again stop, stand up, and make this small exercise that I'm gonna include in this video in a second, where you would bring blood to your hands and that blood would release any tension in your muscles.
Come on, I can do it, I can do it. Is it becoming harder and harder to play? Why? God, I'm scared now, something is wrong with my hands. Never mind, my hands can do it, it's just a fear. Oh no, my hands cannot do it. What is this feeling? Heaviness, weakness, and some aching? What is happening? Oh god, what if I get tendinitis or something? What if I can't do it ever now? Okay, wait. I just need to better treat and care for my hands. Nothing is wrong with me. It's just a part of this practicing. Let's breathe. Yes, I'll just give my hands some rest. Now gently try again. Oh, is it better? Thank God. Oh my God, it's better. Hands are lighter and stronger. Now it's so much easier to play. Wow.
So by taking care of your hands while practicing on this stage, you simply keep yourself away from any injuries and also from these very harmful thoughts that you might have injured your hands. That's it for today. I hope you had some fun watching this video and could relate to something that I showed you here. And always remember that we are making this stage very well. So at the end, we could forget about everything we've done, we could let go about any task that we need to follow in our mind, so we could completely focus on just emotional image, playing with open heart and express everything through artistry. And for those who are not my students yet, you're welcome to my Skype lessons or to pass my retraining program.
all the details in the description below. And thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye bye.